Gary Payton on the other side. Like Rick Barry, a Hall of Famer, and he'd love nothing more than to keep his team's perfect record intact.
Well, they want to do exactly what Trilogy did last year, which is go undefeated and win the championship.
Oh, kick it.
But they got their work cut out for them right now.
Evans bottled up, fouled by Childress. So Evans with Woods and Abdul-Rauf start the second half.
Put the fouls back
for the three-headed monsters. Evans coming off a 10-point, 6-rebound game last week. He's won the Big Three Player of the Week award twice over the first 5 weeks this season.
Well, he's came back with a kind of a renewed energy, an improved offensive game, where now his teammates trust him enough to get him the ball on the block and know now that he does have the ability to finish.
Get the fouls
back. Foul committed by Reggie Evans. Ball Hawks with Childress, Owens, and Taylor on the court as we begin the second half. Childress takes it all away.
But I like the move because
that's the way to attack. We just got to keep attacking.
Three-headed monsters were playing for a pick and roll, but Josh Childress comes to the middle. Immediately he saw the baseline was wide open. One, two dribbles there, he's able to finish. Again, it's all about recognition,
Kenny. I'm challenging that.
He saw Reggie Evans was playing for the pick.
Reggie
jumped to his left side. He was like, to his right side.
You called
it. You
called green ball, right?
Reggie trying to run through.
You said green. You said green. I'm challenging. Yeah.
Rick Barry does not agree with the
call
made by the officials.
You called green. I'm challenging. I think Reggie hit.
Let's go back to this earlier. When they thought it was a challenge, he didn't want a challenge. He made sure he wanted to hold on to that at a better situation at a better time. So let's see if it will pay off for
him. You come right here.
This building right here.
There's an entry pass coming in. You see Childress has his hand and it touches his hand there. Does it go on for Reggie? I can't really see his Reggie Evans' left hand. Looking from this angle. Yeah,
looks like it did.
Yeah.
Rick Barry challenging the call, and it certainly appears as if he will win the challenge.
Yeah. And that's a good use of a challenge right there, because every possession counts for this Ball Hawks team. So you don't want to give up possessions and give three-headed monsters an opportunity to kind of score and get back in this and cut the lead.
Players checking it out on the big screen here in Toronto. It will be Ball Hawks basketball. Rick Barry wins the challenge. Ball Hawks with a 6-point lead. Here's Owens.
Oh, man. That's
and it's rebounded
layups.
By Reggie Evans.
That's four layups not going.
Get up.
Abdul-Rauf inside. Evans back out. And Woods hits a three.
But again, that's about the fourth layup that the Ball Hawks have missed.
Four. It's all right.
And then three-headed monsters are able to capitalize off of it. You got to be able to finish those shots when you get those opportunities at the rim.
3-point lead for the Ball Hawks. Childress off balance, not hit the rim, so Woods plays it right back up and in.
Yeah.
Okay.
For like unanswered points.
You can't tell me
right
that that was
by
not
three-headed
a foul.
Monsters.
Seriously.
I know Rick Barry was not happy that
that just killed
Josh Childress wasn't able to pick up that foul.
First to 50 wins. You must win by two. There's Childress. Woods with the rebound. Evans.
Get it clear.
Reggie Evans now with 9 points to lead the way for the three-headed monsters. They take a 1-point lead.
He never cleared the lane.
And you notice on that last play, Josh Childress kind of let Reggie
he
Evans
never cleared the lane.
Just have the ball and his contention is that what you have to do, if you're a post player, you have to clear the lane when the ball gets advanced outside. And their contention is that Reggie Evans never stepped outside of the lane.
So the officials will take a look.
You got to treat that like a bait. That's bullshit. You got fouled. It's so ridiculous that they didn't call that foul.
I'm going to slide on the screen. Can't get through.
Who got that victory app on the phone? Who got that victory app on the phone? I got a victory t-shirt.
Should be an easy call for the officials that time. Reggie Evans didn't get outside the lane. Here, Ball Hawks able to get down the lane. And this is the play right here where Coach Rick Barry was unhappy that Josh Childress didn't pick up that foul on Reggie Evans, saying there was a lot of physical contact, and Reggie was able to nudge Josh with his chest just enough to throw that shot off.
Officials checking out the last play.
Well, here it is. Reggie's still in the lane, still in the lane, still in the lane. That's why Josh Childress just backed away.
And Childress pointed it out right away.
I said I got another season, okay? Anybody ready to come down court side? Make some noise!
He never cleared.
They got possession, he was already outside of the lane. He walked into the lane, and that's when he laid the ball up.
No, he closed the lane.
So when they got possession, he's outside the lane, he walked into the lane. And that's what we got. So the basket will stand.
Well, what the officials are saying is that on the possession, he was outside of the lane, and then he walked into the lane.
Seven straight points for the three-headed monsters, Mike.
I think the question is, how many big three players, coaches, and referees does it take to review a call?
They should have asked you to come in.
Listen, I'm the only one who saw it. I'm the one with unprecedented access. I'm standing on the court during the game, that was...
What'd you see?
I'm not gonna second guess the decision. The decision was the decision, and it is fine. But I do... And I just want to let you know something. I have lawyers paying attention. Every time you guys say unprecedented access, you're putting yourself in breach. Okay? I have a patent on it. Like Pat Riley has 3 feet. I have a patent on unprecedented access. I'm just saying.
We want to hear you say it 10 times in a row. As quickly as you can.
I'll gas myself out.
3-point lead for the three-headed monsters. They've scored 9 in a row. Childress off the back of the rim. This is Kentel Woods into the paint. Reggie Evans up with the left hand, and Andy has 13 points, and that's 11 straight for his team.
Well, he initiates so much contact. That time he just put his right shoulder right into the chest of Josh Childress, able to back him up. But this is the time right here where there it is. Ball hauls down. They can't settle for jump shots. You have to continue to attack off the dribble, because now you've gone into a scoring slump that allowed three-headed monsters to come back and take the lead.
Grant put an end to the run. Three-headed monsters lead by 3. First team to 50 wins the game. Here's Evans. Evans has had the hot hand. It's chased down by Jermaine Taylor. Taylor spinning inside on Woods.
Quickness, and then able to change directions, keep the spin move tight enough that allows him, once he came out, Kenny, to still be on balance and finish right at the basket.
13 for Taylor. Kick basketball. 1 point game here in Toronto.
And quick move stop. Bam. Spin move right into the heart of the defense and able to spin it. Instead of going wide, he kept it tight. Jermaine Taylor did. Get an easy finish right there.
Three-headed Monsters at 5-0. They have already clinched a playoff berth. Ball Hogs at 1-4. Looking to stay alive. Back to Mike.
I think I have what is the question of the year. Sense of humor, wit. William asked me, is the four-point shot still worth 4 points in Canada? Or did we convert to the metric system up here? William, very witty question. It is still a four-point shot. It is still very valuable. It is still in play. I think when the Big Three goes to Europe, they might consider changing it, though, because of the money system.
Great question.
Ball touched the rim.
With the exchange rate, it might be worth 3.5 points.
Well, it may be. I'll tell you what, it's expensive. You know, I'm a cigar smoker, man. I went to a shop here and I looked at some of the prices. I was like, jeez.
Yeah, but you feel a little better once you see what it costs in the U.S.
Well, I got a great connect, so my connect is always pretty good. You know, you always got to have a connect. Somebody can take care of you.
Why does it not surprise me?
Yeah, see, I have unprecedented access on great connects on Cuban cigars.
Unprecedented.
My lawyers are listening to the game. You're playing with fire. I got some great questions here. Facebook Live questions. Ask me, how would Phil Jackson be as a Big Three coach running the triangle offense? Jimmy, what do you think about that? Can you run the triangle with just three players?
Yeah, you can. But you can run it on one side of the court. I think it's actually tougher to guard because there's so many cuts and moves that you can make without trying to beat somebody one-on-one. Guys don't want to switch. Guys late talk. You get some backdoor cuts and jump shots. All you do is read the defense.
Maybe Phil comes out of retirement.
That ain't gonna happen. Can't pay him enough.
Yet another review. Question is, did this shot hit the rim?
Yes. Easy decision right here. Won't even need Michael Rapaport for this.
Did you say Michael Rapaport?
I did.
Oh, okay. I just, if you need me, trust me, I have access anywhere in this building.
He did not say unprecedented access. No basket.
Yeah, we got to help.
Shot did hit the rim, and they did not take it back out. 1 point lead for the three-headed Monsters here in Toronto. Stevenson on the floor with Owens and Childress for the Ball Hogs. This is Owens guarded by Woods. Sean Stevenson puts one up over Jamario Moon, and it's rebounded by Reggie Evans.
Yeah, tough shot right there. That time by Deshaun Stevenson over, trying to get over the top of the longer Jamario Moon.
Evans, nice touch.
And that's kind of tough because if you're Josh Childress, you really don't want to go out that far. You want to force Reggie to make that shot, and he made him pay.
3 point lead for the three-headed Monsters. The only unbeaten team in the Big Three this season. Here's Owens from downtown. Boom, guys in for the rebound, then had it knocked away.
Huh?
Jermaine Taylor checks back in for the Ball Hogs, replacing Andre Owens. Now Taylor with the scoop. He's fouled. There it is, guys. The four-point circle, 9.1 meters, 30 feet from the basket.
Make this free throw. Yes.
So you ask, we answer.
We always got the solution, the answers here. So we do it the Big Three, baby. Peter Greasy, run some numbers there. Got it. Answered. Facebook question.
Peter knew it off the top of his head.
No, he was already calculating.
No calculator needed. There's Evans with the left hand. 17 for Reggie Evans. First to 50 wins. 3-point lead for the three-headed monsters. Here's Taylor. Evans with another rebound.
Oh my God.
Evans has had the hot hand tonight. Back out for Moon. Moon driving on Childress. Here is Taylor for three. Childress takes it inside.
That's where they keep the ball alive. That time I thought Jermaine Taylor thought about that shot too long.
Go, yellow.
And really didn't have his feet up on the right. But luckily they were able to keep it alive and get a basket inside.
1-point game, three-headed monsters with the lead. Off the steal. Paul Hodge now with an opportunity to go back on top. Childress. Nice move by Evans.
Oh my gosh.
But he did not get the roll.
Well, you know, and that one was tough because it was another missed layup. But Reggie kind of pulled the chair from underneath Josh Childress, so he really wasn't on balance to finish that. But it still goes down as another missed opportunity. I talked about a renewed sense of enthusiasm in regards to Reggie Evans' offensive game. We've seen it all year. He's been able to score the ball down low, finish, knock down some jump shots.
Well, points here in the second half for Reggie Evans. Mike.
Steven asked, how have the fans been city to city, the crowd hype? It's been fantastic, Steven. Last year was great. This year is even better. Every single week it gets more and more exciting. Gerard said if Jimmy played, would his team win the big three? Jimmy Jackson, and I have to say this. I don't think Jimmy Jackson has anything left in the tank. I think that Brian Scalabrine would put up 30 on Jimmy Jackson. I'll let Jimmy answer that in a second. Right now I have the microphone. Would I beat Skip Bayless in a one-on-one? Absolutely. Gerard said, who's the coach of the year? Right now it's got to be Gary Payton in that play call to win that game a couple of weeks ago. And Tyler asked this. I'll throw this to you guys. Reggie Evans is so underrated. Do you think he can make it in the NBA, fellas? That was from Tyler.
Can I answer the question now?
Oh, about Scalabrine dropping 30 on you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Scalabrine, first of all, never dropped 30 in NBA games, let alone on me. And second, yes, my team would win. Because I would stack it. I would stack my team. And I still got something in the tank. I just don't want to use it yet.
We got a fact check. Did Scalabrine ever get 30?
Well, I'm just... off the top of my head, I don't remember seeing it or hearing about it, because it would have been national news if it did happen.
I understand you second guessing it. I understand. I got with you on it.
We'll be sure to find out.
Yeah,
Pete, how about the last
Pete,
question about Reggie
where
Evans?
You at? Which part? I'm all going off the mic. What was the last question again?
About Reggie Evans.
Could Reggie Evans play in the NBA today?
Well, you know what, though? Actually, the way Reggie's biggest strength when he played, he hustled, he rebounded, he played defense. Scoring wasn't in his game at that time because he was a smaller, undersized forward. Well, right now, the way the NBA is, with everybody switching, I think it benefits the plays right into a great block right there. It plays into a guy like Reggie Evans that was limited offensively back in the past, but right now would be able to be a little bit effective, I would think, in the post.
Taylor nails a three. By the way, our guy, Peter Gracie, has crunched the numbers. Brian Scalabrine's career high in the NBA, 29.
Thank you.
I'm with you.
29.
Wow. Don't test me, Michael Rapaport. Wow. 30 on me. Are you kidding me?
Oh. Hey. Think about bad breaks and let the ball go out of bounds.
That was back in 2005, a 29-point game. Now a Celtics analyst and also... a co-host on Sirius XM, the NBA radio channel, along with Frank Isola. They do a terrific job together.
I'm going to ask Peter Griese, was that mop-up garbage time when the points came? What was the score to that game? I need to know all the history behind that game.
We didn't say it was against you.
No, I'm saying I need to know all the history.
It's hard to get away with the streak.
It was against the Warriors back in 2005.
What was the score to that game? Was it a blowout? Was it?
Deshaun Stevenson. Remember, you must win by two. First team to 50. Three-headed monster is now at 45. Woods into the paint. Evans fouled up by Owens.
Our ball. Greenball. Greenball.
Nice help.
Brian Scalabrini's Nets won the game by 14 over the Warriors when he scored 29.
Yeah, so it must have been a wider margin of point spread in order for Scal to be in the game that late.
Deshaun, come here. Over here. Set a screen for him.
We're going to.
Yeah.
Stay right here. Deshaun, go to the corner.
You know, it's interesting, too. In late game situations, you'll see this lineup by three-headed monsters, and Mahmoud will be on the bench. And then Gary kind of inserts him in the last few possessions to kind of close out the game.
Stevenson keeps it alive. Shot clock at one. Evans with yet another rebound. Here is Woods from three.
Oh my God.
Kept alive by Moon. Evans. 47-41 lead for the three-headed monsters. 20 points for Reggie Evans.
Loose ball situation. When things are not going your way, you're losing games.
Break.
The ball just doesn't seem to bounce your way. That time the ball was right in the possession of Ball Hawk, but it just bounced to Jamario Moon, who's able now to go in and get his team closer to winning this game.
I'm seeing the same thing that Jimmy said. The ball is just not bouncing the Ball Hawk's way. No pun intended. You know, they're still in this game, but they're a three-point basket away from losing. They're playing hard. They're playing better. They're just not getting the breaks. I'm really digging the Facebook Live questions. Sonny talked about Corey Maggette, his performance. He's yoked. He's doing his thing. He's trying to shout out Trent and say, who's the most improved from last year?
You get Reggie on you.
That's a good question. I have to say Reggie Evans, I think, is the most improved player this year, Preston. Ben said, who's the best lockdown defender in the big three? I'll throw that to Jimmy Jackson. Jimmy, who do you think is the toughest defender in this league?
That's a great question, man. I think Reggie plays that role extremely well because he plays physical. He can get out and guard. Yeah, you know who I think also is most improved, and I said this before, David Oakley.
Three-headed monsters win it with a three. Here's Evans, and he's fouled.
They get the ball back. Wow.
Gary Payton's club at 5-0. They've already clinched the playoff berth. 3 points away from the defeat of the Ball Hogs. With the Ball Hogs lost, they would be eliminated if Three's Company beats Tri-State in our third game tonight.
Well, Reggie Evans makes this shot. Now they're able to retain possession to finish the game. And that's the beauty about getting in the penalty. Woo!
A free throw plus possession. 2 points on the free throw.
And why not go to Evans? He's been able to score at will all game. See if he can close it out.
Shot clock violation.
Yeah, that time Reggie should have shot it. And he's pointing to Gary Payton and saying, yeah, that's my bad. I should have put it up. That's why you go to him.
Here's Children spinning inside. Three-headed monsters will pick up their sixth victory in six games with their next bucket.
That's a moving screen.
Here's Moon. Puts it up. Remember, he hit the game winner last week. Here's Owens. He's fouled. I can tell Woods.
They're not in the building, right?
Down to
Here's Abdul-Rauf back in, as you predicted, Jimmy.
Again, you bring Mahmoud back in. You're going to run a pick and roll with him. And you're going to force the defense to have to make a decision on how they're going to play that pick and roll. In particular, if you run it with Jamaria Moon, who can step back and shoot. So it puts the defense in a tough situation on how to guard it. Do we switch it? If you go under, Mahmoud can beat you. If you're a little bit late, one dribble, he can beat you. If not, he can hit it back to Jamario. So let's see how the Ball Hawks guard it. This time they're running with Reggie Evans.
Evans back to Abdul-Rauf. Here is Evans for the win. So the three-headed monsters remain unbeaten at 6-0. The Ball Hawks dropped to 1-5.
Again, Mahmoud puts you in a situation. How do I guard the pick and roll? Josh Childress has to come up a little bit in order to force Mahmoud not to have an open shot. And as a smart, intelligent point guard, what do? Don't have the shot? Got an opening pocket pass? Easy money that time for Reggie Evans.
Evans finishes with 24. The three-headed monsters outscore the Ball Hawks in the second half, 31-19. 6-0. Gary Payton's three-headed monsters heading to the postseason. Ball Hawks dropped to 1-5. Join us at the top of the hour. Three more games coming up on FS1. For Jim Jackson, Mike Rappaport, this is Kenny Albert. So long on Facebook Live.